The Cargill Albion starch mill is, according to the residents of Grays in Essex, making their lives a misery. The problem, a nauseating smell like burned potatoes and a white starchy fallout. Now they've organised a 3,000 signature petition, which they intend to deliver to the Prime Minister. They claim the factory may be a health hazard.
It's so bad that even with the draft excluders around our windows, the smoke still gets in.
I'd had aches for years, but not as bad as this. I mean, I'm vomiting and that. When you smell it, I mean, you can't, it turns you off your foot.
Oh, well, I get up in the morning, I keep choking, and this morning it come out and I go, I'm losing my voice.
Well, the hardest thing I find is you've got to sleep all night with your windows closed. If you don't, you can smell it all night long. It's absolutely disgraceful.
The problem started more than 4 years ago. In 1979, the local council, Thurrock, promised to take legal action. But according to residents organiser Jim Moore, nothing has happened.
We want this smell and we want this starch stopped. I am giving them council a fortnight. Or I will ask the people of Thurrock at my meeting on the 2nd of October to withhold their rates until this lazy council gets off and do something.
The company declined to be interviewed, but they say they are aware of the problem and they're continuing to work on emission controls.
The council too have declined to be interviewed. They say they are concerned about the problem, but insist there's no positive evidence of a health risk.
But people are still worried, particularly about a local junior school near to the mill.
This little girl is actually, yep. she's waiting to go to London Hospital, this little girl, for her throat and that, you know. We don't know if it's due to the smell, but it all could, you know, could be.
How does the smell affect you?
I don't like it, makes my throat sore, it makes me feel sick.
I keep getting tummy aches and I have to stay in bed. And I had it last week and it keeps coming.
The council executive meet on Wednesday to consider their legal position. Residents say if there's no positive action, they'll withhold their rates, and that's only the beginning. Roger Parry in Grays for Thames News.